Hello everyone, my name is Cheney Hu, Sangfor HCI Product Manager. In this video, I'd like to give you a brief introduction to our disaster recovery solution based on HCI. Lots of customers are using our HCI as their virtualized infrastructure to run their most business-critical applications. To protect their workloads, we also have multi-copy of their data stored on ASAN, which is our storage virtualization, and we also have backup and CDP to protect their business-critical data in the event of cluster failure. However, we do know a lot of customers want to protect their business due to extend the protection to another site. If any disaster hits their primary site, they can fail over their business to the secondary site to ensure the business continuity of their business. So, Sangfor HCI came out with a one-stop disaster recovery solution based on our hyperconverged infrastructure platform. So how does it work? As you can see here, I've already drawn two sites, and we can deploy two clusters on the two sides. Primary site, let's call it site A, and the secondary site, let's call it site B. So because site A is worked as my primary infrastructure for the applications, most of my applications will be running on site A. So I can deploy a higher end servers, a servers with higher end specifications on site A. And because secondary site, site B, serves as a disaster recovery site, so I can deploy servers with lower specs to reduce the capex. And if I deploy a disaster recovery solution on the two sides, first, of course, these two sides need to be connected. Let's say they are connected by a VPN dedicated line between the two sides. And I need to activate my disaster recovery license on the HCI. So we have an ADR module that is deeply integrated in the kernel of our platform. So with ADR enabled at the two sides, they communicate with each other and the data will be transferred from the module at site A to the module at site B. So our disaster recovery solution is managed by our cloud management platform. Previously, it was called ACMP. Now it's called SCP, Sangfor Cloud Platform. So you need to deploy SCP at the two sides. And because our disaster recovery solution is a policy-based management solution, so if you need to apply disaster recovery for a particular workload, let's say I have a VM1 that I want to extend the protection for it to another side, then I can initiate a policy on the web UI of our SCP. And after the policy is initialized, there will be a placeholder VM of VM1 that is created on the site B. Let's call it VM1B. So this VM1B is a placeholder VM for VM1. And the disaster recovery solution built by HCI is a local backup plus remote replication solution. That means there is a backup file of that VM, which is stored on the primary side. Usually, that backup file is stored on an external storage. It could be a SAN, or it could be a NAS. They could be legacy storage. Okay, it's connected to the HCI. So after the disaster recovery kicks into effect, the VM's data, first there will be a full backup of the VM's QCAL2 file. So let's say the QCAL2 file of this VM is stored on ASAN. And because, you know, DR is initiated, so I will do a backup of that kcal2 file to the external storage, because this external storage is the backup repository. And then, based on your DR policy, okay, the DR policy, I can specify the RPO. The minimum RPO is 1 second, as long as the storage and the corresponding secondary side has the sufficient performance to cope with that I/O flow, and the bandwidth is big enough to pump those big amount of data from the primary side to the secondary side, you can set the RPO as minimum as 1 second. Or, you know, commonly customer may set it to be, you know, hourly, let's say 1 hour, or, you know, 4 hours, or, you know, 1 day. It's up to their application's requirement. They can configure the RPO of the disaster recovery solution for different VMs. So like I said, you know, the backup will be done on the local side, and the ADR, as the disaster recovery manager, it will copy the backup file from the backup repository and then transfer it through the dedicated line to the secondary side. Let's say here, there will be a kcal2, you know, a backup kcal2 file. Let's call it the kcal2b. So that is the backup file of the corresponding kcal2 primary file on the secondary side, okay? The ADR leverages the backup or CDP feature that we have to do a backup and to do a, you know, IO log caching to the external storage, and then copy that backup from the primary side to the secondary side. You know, these two ADR modules, they can talk with each other, and the data is transmitted between them from the primary to the secondary. So what if this primary side goes down? Let's say something bad, something, you know, unexpected hit this primary side, and the power is failed, you know, this side goes down. What we can do is, because, you know, the SCP, we, you know, keep syncing the information, I mean the environment information of the cluster from the primary SCP. So I can cut over to the SCP here at the secondary side. I can log in to the SCP here, and then I can go to my backup file, which is synced from the primary side to the secondary side, you know, this kcal2b. I can go to that file and recover my VM1 from the VM1b, okay? This VM1b will have all the data, you know, nearly all the data. You know, if you configure the RPO to be 1 second, that means every 1 second, you know, the data is transmitted, is synced to the kcal2b file, you know, by the ADR. So basically, I can have my VM quickly recovered. It's an instant recovery. I just go to the SCP, standby SCP, and recover the VM. So in that way, you can quickly fail over your business in the event of primary side failure. So usually, you know, when the primary side goes back, let's say, you know, the site A is back online, and because this site has, you know, my best equipment, my best servers, so I'd like to migrate my workloads from the secondary side back to my primary side. So it is also easy to be operated on HCI. What I can do is I just fail my business back to the primary side, and it is a incremental failback. That means it's not, you know, after failover, my VM1 is running here, and there will be some new data created. So if I need to fail back, not all of the data is moved back to site A. Only the new data is moved back. Let's say maybe here I have data 1, 2, 3, and after, you know, the VM is failed over to site B, maybe it have 1, 2, 3, you know, intact. And when the VM1B is running here, it could have 4 and 5 created at site B. So when I fail it back, I want to, you know, move my VM1 back to my primary site. I only move 4 and 5. To the site A to reduce the bandwidth consumption in the event of, you know, a failback. So as you can see, you know, the disaster recovery solution on HCI is a local backup plus remote replication disaster recovery solution. We call it, you know, active standby. The site A serves as a primary site. Site B serves as a secondary site for, you know, backup for disaster recovery purpose. And to control the bandwidth here, the ADR has a lot of features, functionalities to help you control the data transfer between the two sites. It can have, you know, a flow control. So with flow control, I can limit the bandwidth consumption by the DR traffic, okay? Because maybe there are some production traffic, you know, come and go in the pipe. You know, if I need to, you know, make sure that my DR traffic doesn't impact my production traffic, I can, you know, apply a flow control. And let's say if here I have a 100 megabyte of, you know, bandwidth, I can just assign, let's say, 50 megabit per second to my disaster recovery. And second, we also support, you know, link compression. That means, you know, the data, the backup data that ADR needs to send over to the secondary site will be compressed first. You need to check that compression box. Then the compression will kick in to compress your backup data to make sure, you know, to reduce the size that it needs to be transferred to the secondary site. It also supports encryption. That means the data, the backup data that needs to be transferred to the secondary site is encrypted on the fly. So, you know, you can make sure that your data is secured by the encryption. So with this disaster recovery solution based on HCI, customer can have a one-stop disaster recovery solution to protect their data, to protect their business continuity. With our local backup plus remote replication mechanism we built in into the disaster recovery flow mechanism, you know, if one node goes down, I can have high availability because ASAM has multiple copies. If the entire cluster goes down, I can still have my data, you know, being intact without any compromise on my external backup storage. If this entire site goes down, I have my secondary site that can be, you know, can service my business. We can support, you know, as minimum as 1 second RPO for your for your most mission critical applications. And also, this disaster recovery is extremely easy to use. It doesn't involve any third-party components. Everything is integrated. You do not need to install anything. You just need to, you know, install the SCP from Sangfor. It's like a virtual image. You upload it to HCI and then do some simple configuration. You can have the disaster recovery management right away. And we also provide you a visualized disaster recovery monitoring with big screen displaying the traffic, the RPO compliance of your applications. So everything is done on your at your fingertip. It's extremely easy to operate and also easy to maintenance. So with that is Sangfor disaster recovery solution built on HCI. If you want to know more about our disaster recovery solution, please visit our official website. Thank you.